Today we will be discussing a very important topic that many students fail to understand, the orthogonal intersection of two circles. First, let's learn what is an orthogonal intersection. Let's take these two intersecting circles. At the point of intersection, we'll draw two tangents, one tangent for each circle. Now, these tangents will make a certain angle theta between each other. This angle theta will vary based on the position of the two circles. So, at a certain position of these two circles, the angle theta will be equal to 90 degrees. So, when theta equals 90 degrees, it is called an orthogonal intersection. Now that you know what an orthogonal intersection is, let's go into the special properties and equations of an orthogonal intersection. For two circles to intersect orthogonally, there exists a necessary and sufficient condition. The tangent of one circle will pass through the center of the other circle. So let's take these two circles S1 and S2. Here S1 is x squared plus y squared plus 2g1x plus 2f1y plus c1 equals 0. While S2 is x squared plus y squared plus 2g2x plus 2f2y plus c2 equals 0. Their centers will be O1 minus G1 minus F1 and O2 minus G2 minus F2. So when S1 and S2 intersect orthogonally, the angle A will be 90 degrees. Since these two are vertically opposite angles, the angle O1A O2 will also be equal to 90 degrees. So this triangle O1A O2 will be a right angle triangle, so it will obey the Pythagoras theorem. So that means that we can interpret this as O1O2 squared equals O1A squared plus O2A squared. So the distance O1O2 can be found using the distance formula that we learned before. You can click this info card to learn about this distance formula. So O1O2 squared equals minus G1 minus G2 whole thing squared plus minus F1 minus F2 whole thing squared equals O1A squared. So here O1A is the radius of this circle. So that is g squared plus f squared minus c. So we get O1A squared as g1 squared plus f1 squared minus c1. And O2A is the radius of this second circle. So that will be g2 squared plus f2 squared minus c2. When we open these brackets, g1 squared, g2 squared, f1 squared and f2 squared will cancel off. Finally, we get our equation 2 into g1 g2 plus f1 f2 equals c1 plus c2. This is the equation for two circles which intersect orthogonally. Let's take an example to understand this better. Here, we are asked to show that the two circles S1 and S2 intersect orthogonally. So here, S1 is given as x squared plus y squared minus 4y minus 5 equals 0. And S2 is given as 2x squared plus 2y squared minus 3x plus 6y minus 2 equals 0. First, before working on our question, we need to make S2 in our standard form. That is, the coefficient of x squared and y squared should be 1. So to do this, we divide the whole equation by 2. So that gives us x squared plus y squared minus 3 upon 2x plus 3y minus 1 equals 0. So now that we have in our standard form, we can go on with our question. question. So we know that when two circles intersect orthogonally, they obey the equation 2 into g1 g2 plus f1 f2 equals c1 plus c2. So now let's take the left hand side of this equation. So that will be 2 into g1. Here we can find that g1 equals 0 since there is no x here. So and f1 will be minus 4 divided by 2. So that will give us minus 2. Similarly, g2 will be minus 3 upon 2 divided by 2. So that will be minus 3 upon 4. So f2 will be 3 upon 2. So that gives us 2 into 0 plus minus 2 into 3 upon 2. So that will give us minus 6. Now let's take the right hand side of the equation. So that is equal to c1 plus c2. Here c1 equals minus 5 and c2 equals minus 1. So that gives us minus 6. So here LHS is equal to RHS. So since the left hand side and the right hand side of this equation is equal, we can say that the two circles S1 and S2 intersect orthogonally. So now I hope that you understood what an orthogonal intersection is. That's all for today's video. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comment section below. Until we meet again, take care.